such as the glories of the devotee of Krishna. But if one thinks, or to that much a devotee manifests the 26 good qualities, then to that degree he is a sadhu, and to that degree he does not manifest the 26 qualities, then to that degree he is not a sadhu. To think in that way is offense or aparad, because the real quality of sadhu, they are completely surrendered to Krishna. Therefore, even if a one-pointed sadhu is bad in character, one should not criticize him. By chanting the holy name quickly, his faults will be destroyed and he will be pure. If one thinks, if I blaspheme a Mahabhagavat and Uttam Vaishnava, there can be no problem, because such a devotee is free from the desire for praise and free from being disappointed when he is blasphemed. Therefore, because he never accepts any offense by blaspheming, there's no question of Vaishnava aparad. And if he accepts aparad, that means he cannot be a Vaishnava. We should not think that. An Uttam Vaishnava never accepts any offense, but his foot dust, his chaladuli, his foot dust will not forgive us. And his foot dust will be offended by our behavior. Just see the example of Durvasa Rishi. He made offense to the great devotee, Ambarish. He went to Brahma, Shiva, and even Narayan, but they would not forgive him because he made Durvasa make offense to the foot dust of Ambarish Maharaj. Ambarish Maharaj never considered that he had been offended. Therefore, Sri Habi, one of the Namayogendras, the 11th canto, he described the symptom of the Uttam Vaishnava, Sarva Bhutashriya Pasya Bhagavad Bhagavad Atmanaha, who sees Vishnu in all living entities and who sees all living entities in Vishnu or his worshipful deity, that person is called Mahabhagavat. Just like Prahlad Maharaj, he saw his Ishtadeva inside everything, even inside the stone pillar. And he saw all living entities inside his Ishtadeva. Therefore, Prahlad Maharaj, he never took offense by the bad behavior of Hiranyakasipu. Even though Hiranyakasipu tried to throw him in fire, gave him poison, tried to chop him into pieces, had him fed to snakes and elephants, but Prahlad Maharaj never took offense. But still, Hiranyakasipu was destroyed by the offense he made to the foot dust of Prahlad Maharaj. There was such a person who continued making more offense, more offense, more offense, until they destroy themselves. Such is the power of Maya on that person who makes offense. That person never thinks, I am committing Vaishnava aparad. He thinks, I am telling the true thing. So, and then on the other hand, if one thinks, well, maybe I did make offense to pure Vaishnava or Gurudev, but because he is not interested in being praised also, there is no need in begging forgiveness or following his instruction, serving him or offering prayers to him. No, don't think like this. You have to do. You have to beg forgiveness if you make offense to a Vaishnava. Just see another example in the Bhagavatam, Daksha, Prajapati Daksha. He made offense to Lord Shiva. Lord Shiva never accepted any offense, but he was destroyed by his aparad. Or just see the example of Chitraketu. Chitraketu Maharaj was a perfected soul, and he saw Shiva without any clothes embracing Parvati and giving Harikata. Then Chitraketu laughed, ah, just see Lord Shiva, what he's doing. Shiva smiled, he knew, oh my god brother is making some joke. Therefore Shiva was not offended, but the foot dust of Shiva, Parvati, foot dust means the follower. Uma, she took offense to the offense that Chitraketu made to Shiva, and she cursed him to become a demon, Vrishasura. Therefore one should be very, very careful. Even a sadhu has no good qualities, but they have taken shelter of Harinam in a one-pointed mood, one should not blaspheme him in any way. Go up, Prema.
Krishna Vatakuri. Hare Krishna. অনেক ভক্তগণ বৃন্দাবনে এবং গোবর্ধনে হরিনাম দীক্ষা নিয়েছেন, তাদের জন্য জানাচ্ছি আগামীকাল বেলা 10টার সময় পূজ্যপাদ তীর্থ মহারাজ বৈষ্ণবহন করবেন। যারা এখনো ভোট করেন নাই তারা কালকে দশটার পূর্বে কুন্দন করিয়ে নেবেন যারা হরিনাম দীক্ষা যারা দীক্ষা নিয়েছেন। কুছ ভক্ত লোক বৃন্দাবন মে গোবর্ধন দীক্ষা লে চুকে হ্যাঁ, উনকে লিয়ে হবন হোনা হ্যায়, উপনয়ন সংস্কার হোনা হ্যায়, কাল 10 বজে তীর্থ মহারাজ করেঙ্গে। জো লোক দীক্ষা কে সময় সময় নেই মিলা, ছৌর কার্য নেই করা হ্যায়, মুন্ডন নেই করাযা, কাল সুবে সুবে করা লে, উপনয়ন সংস্কার পেলে মুন্ডন হোনা চাহিয়ে। Some devotees take an initiation in Govardhan and Vrindavan, but due to lack of time they could not make their saving. So before tomorrow 10 a.m. have to shave their hairs and after 10 sacrifice for male devotee only. कुछ भक्त लोग नोएडा विभिन्न स्थान से आए हैं, लोग दीक्षा लेना चाहते हैं, उनके लिए कल की 9 बजे दीक्षा होगी, 10 बजे हवन होगा। যারা আমার দীক্ষা নিতে চান তাদের কালকে 9টার সময় দীক্ষা, 10টার সময় হবন। যে লোক দীক্ষা নিতে চাহতে হ্যাঁ উনকে লিয়ে কাল 9 বজে টাইম হ্যাঁ, 10 বজে হবন হোগা। হরে কৃষ্ণ
হরে কৃষ্ণ। Another beautiful calendar has appeared today for the Cheshire Srila Gurudev and all the Vaishnavas. It's very beautiful. With paintings, original paintings, and all the Ekadasi duties, Vaishnava holidays available, also on the previous calendar, the big one, all the Vaishnava holidays and Ekadasi duties are available. So this is, put on your desk. You can show it, put it on the desk. Put it on the desk, on your desk. It's available for everyone for only 50 rupees. If you order more, you can get it for a better price either. Hare Krishna. Then, lost and found, the devotees have lost their cell phones and their watches. Anyone who has found a watch or a cell phone, please bring them to us. Anything you find, bring them to Shripad Tirtha Maharaj, Shripad Madhavaras, or myself. And if you miss anything, please call and ask us.
And passports, running out of time. Things are still getting missing, even from rooms. So for the next 2 days, between 4 and 5 o'clock, before class, bring your valuables to be locked up until the end of Harikram. Please do it. Please, please, please. Hare Krishna.
আগামী পাল্লা বিদ্যাপুর হ্যাঁ, ইসলিয়ে কল বিশ্রাম দিয়া গেলো। লোক চা রে যমুনা মে মথুরা যা করকে স্নান করেঙ্গে, উসমে স্নান করলে সে ফির যম কাল কোই ফায়দ নেই হোতা হ্যায়, क्योंकि उसकी बहनें वो कृपा कर देती हैं जिससे कि उसका भाई जमराज काली काल से बाहर और उसको, इसलिए बहुत सारे भारत से लोग विशेष करके उत्तर प्रदेश से लोग आए थे जमुना में कल बड़ी भाई दीदी रोय की विश्राम घाट पर सावधानी से जाकर के स्नान
किया। Brother and sister take vows to Muna, and because Muna is the brother of Yamaraj, and that person is not taken by Yamaraj at the time of death. So, God bless you, Muslim. So, if anybody who has their sister and their grandmother go to hell, they can go to the Shram Ghat tomorrow at Muna and take vows together. Go,
brother. Oh, yeah. Krishna Govinda.